How do you relate Africa, Linklaters, Luxembourg? What is your take on it?
There are great opportunities in Africa in terms of infrastructure, commodities, developing businesses, etc. These will all need finance of some sort or another, and therefore, certainly the funds that have established themselves in Luxembourg within the legal environment that has been created within Luxembourg, I think will play an ever increasingly important part. The fintech opportunity that Luxembourg presents, together with the 150 banks, the 300 insurance companies that operate in and out of Luxembourg, I think bringing the two together, I can see that there are good opportunities there.
You simply cannot ignore Africa. It's not too late, but on the other hand, it's not too early, but we should definitely be aware of it, and that's where we sought. We should also maybe create some interest, and not just interest, but awareness in the larger finance and beyond the finance, the business community here in Luxembourg.
I think a couple of things. I think the fact that there are such regional diversities means you really have to understand the region and the country you're in. The only way to do that is to be on the ground, get to know the area and the people. Important to partner up with the right people. It can make a real difference to your business success. I think Africa has traditionally been quite far behind some other jurisdictions, but has now almost leapfrogged a number of those jurisdictions with some really great innovations in different products and in different sectors that has shown Africa to be really first in a number of ways. I do believe that there is a real opportunity for that to change. A lot of the discussion this evening was around infrastructure development, energy development, real investment into those sectors, telecoms and how that is changing, a lot of banking being done on telephones now, a lot of just basic trading done on telephones that is really going to close those gaps between the different areas. So I see it being quite different in the future.
And that's one of the, really the greatest challenges will be how you create opportunities for people on the ground, or you create jobs, good jobs, resilient jobs, and how you, I would say, connect that need with also the investments that you're going to have to make in education. Education is probably priority number one, at least in macroeconomic terms, public health, and other types of things that are important for the population to live and to live well and to be productive.
Everybody knows that the oil prices are a challenge for any new project in the world, but the gas is there, the demand in the world is there, so sooner or later these projects will take place and will be monetized, and it's going to be a game changer in the country, I have no doubt. What is to be seen is how the game will change. Certainly, the government agenda is to use the opportunity to diversify the economy and develop the country. Let's see if it will happen.
When we see Africa from Europe, we assume that it is one single country with one single market, because we are used to see one single market in Europe. It's totally different in Africa. And what is regional integration about? Regional integration is trying to do exactly in Africa what it has been done in Europe or in the US, for example, to expand and to have most important market, and this is the best way to obtain a new growth.
I think currency creates some big challenges, and also I think access to funding. I mean, there's still capital constraints in Africa which are quite strong. There are still relatively few commercial banks operating in Africa. There's lots of liquidity among development finance institutions, international finance institutions, but they tend to be for much larger, more structured deals. The commercial bank appetite is fairly limited for international commercial banks without a lot of political risk cover. And local banks, it tends to be fairly small liquidity or fairly expensive. A few regional players that have become very strong as well. People like Ecobank, Standard Bank, Barclays, Absa, that is the beginning of something really interesting and exciting, and that's happening more and more. It's still relatively modest in terms of it's a handful of countries, but there's something really in that, and it is a start of a trend.